Hello and welcome to News Click. Today we are in Ludhiana reporting from the Indian Women's League, which is India's National Football League. And we are joined by Maymol Rocky, who is the first woman to become a coach of the national football team. She is currently serving as the coach of India's National Women's Senior Football Team. So we are going to talk to her about her journey of rising to this position, what challenges she faces, the current status of India's women's football, and a lot more. So thank you, Maymol ma'am, for joining us today. To start, can you talk about your journey first, from going to from an athlete to a national coach? What kind of obstacles did you face? Why did you come into football in the first place? Can you tell us something about yourself?
I belong to Goa. I played like from my childhood. I'm in Goa, and I was into athletics first. Then I slowly shifted to football. As one of my coach said, it's a good sport, you can join. And I should enjoy seeing my brother playing football. So I started playing football. And maybe within 2 years, I played for the country as a player. And then when I was playing, I had a good guidance from my coaches. So to do my licenses, I should travel with the team as managers earlier, the Goa state team. Then slowly I did all my licenses. In 2012, I was with the national team later on. From 2012, I was with the age group teams, slowly worked hard for it. Now where I am, definitely there will be a lot of hands which have put in, which have helped me to be here. But then from your side also, you have to work hard for it. So I think from my side, I did a lot of hard work to be here. Being a woman, to be here, everybody might know this. It takes a lot of things to be here. So I happy to be here at this position, and I can hold the girls team it is. So I'm a woman myself, so I can understand. I have played for my so I know what is needed, what is wanted. But then yes, still learning from things what I am moving around, and trying to make the best team what I can do for the national team.
So can you tell us more about the sort of obstacles you faced, considering the fact that it is still predominantly a male dominated sport? So even during your training, you might be in spaces which were more, you know, had more male presence. So how, you know, what was that experience like?
As you said, this is a male dominating country. So when you say that word only, you can understand in football, it's more about male. It's a male sport normally. So slowly now it has started taking a change. So but when we were playing or when we were doing all our licenses, it was always male, and you might be the only female in a course. But then the colleagues what I had, they really helped me to, because I was young and wanted to learn more. So it was always with the colleagues what I had, they were really helping me out. But then again, you were highlighted because you were the only female, or maybe the two females who did courses together. But when it comes to a national team, to be a national team coach, hundreds of coaches are around in India to become this. But then I think I was a lucky one, worked hard for it. I believe in God. So I think maybe this was my opportunity. But then while playing also, that time the sports, football was not given that much of importance, but it took time. We played till we could. And I think I was already with the national team also, I should play for the state with the senior team. So there were a lot of problems, but then we had to manage it by ourselves, because my father was into sports. So I come from a sports background. So my father was always interested. So it was no pressure from my family, because they were like supporting me for everything. I got a job in Sports Authority of Goa as a football coach. So again, I was into sports. So it was like we worked hard for it, but you know, being a girl and to be at this position, it really took a lot of things. But then you cannot express this, or you cannot tell it by words, but there were a lot of things. But really, thanks a lot of people who are around. I cannot name people, because there were a lot of people to help me to be here. So I would just say thank you to them who are really supporting me still for this. And again, I will say Federation believes in me. That's why I am here, because I was earlier with the age group team. Slowly, I shifted to the senior team. It was not like suddenly I was in the senior team. Earlier, I was assistant coach and then shifted to the head coach post. So I think, and the girls also, again, the credit goes to the girls. They accepted me as a coach and they believed in me. They worked for me, because finally, it's you what you tell the players. They know they are playing for the national team, but players also are input for me, because now also the way they are supporting me for whatever I'm saying, because finally it's what you say to the girls, they have to do it. So it's not like you can do some magic. Until the girls show it on the field, it becomes difficult. But then I think girls also really supported me for that.
And during your tenure, under your guidance, it has been seen, it has been reported that the football team is performing much better than it was before. They're winning matches and just generally doing better. So can you tell us more about what sort of changes you brought in the team to make this happen?
One thing, I started making them believe in themselves. It's earlier it was like they should think, we might, we can. It was always a question mark. So I just made them believe in themselves. We worked on that, and we had this 4 months in our hand together. The girls were staying together. So we worked hard for that. Plus, the only thing I like in my thing is always playing attacking football, which I made sure the girls also believe in what I tell them to do. Which they, if you see, starting, we had a lot of problems at the start because we were not ready for it. We lost Hero Gold Cup. That was very sad and disappointing in the country. We lost to Nepal, first ever time. But then those were preparation for SAF and Olympic qualifiers round two. And I think once you see, after that, once we play Nepal, we always defeated them like 3-1, a bigger margin. So it's only like the girls need time. And especially I had this young team. Average age was 21 years. So again, they also need time because they have hardly played any international matches. If you count our girls playing them, if you have counted them previously, they might have only reached 20 or 25 international matches in their career. In this 4 months, we have played almost 20 international matches now. So it's like one thing good what the girls got this exposure. Again, if Federation had not believed in us, it would have been difficult. So they believed in the women's team, me and the players. That's why we were here with this good result.
And like you were saying, women, the players were not getting the chance to play so many matches before. This is probably also due to the fact that it is, again, a women's sport, and it is not given as much attention. We have to accept that. At least till now, it is not being given as much attention. So do you feel like this kind of, you know, differential treatment which is given to the sport is also affects the players' morale at the end of the day? Like, even here, for that matter, the match timings are such that they're playing in such, you know, very in such extreme heat, and then the stadium is empty. So that kind of thing, do you think it brings them down a bit, and it needs to be, of course, it needs to be improved. So what do you feel about that?
The problem is not about sports only. It's everywhere. If you see, there's a differentiate between men and female. If it is any job, let it be a media people, anywhere you see, any, not about sports, it's anywhere. But then for me, at least from the time I have started into football, I can see a lot of things happening for women's football. At least I'll talk about women's football. A lot of things happening, a lot of improvement. The accommodations have been better, the travelling has been better. Earlier we should travel by train, and now it's by flight. So the players are also enjoying the best facilities for now. We are travelling. If you see, in this 4 months, almost 2 months, we have been internationally like we were going for this exposure. So, you know, it's not like you cannot say, but things again, I think, need time, and we need to give results also. Otherwise, who will invest money in you? So I think this time the results were better. Federation is like supportive. So a lot of things were happening this time, at least I cannot say about past. Yeah, there were a lot of, when I played, hardly we like, there was no money involved. There was no league there. There was nothing. Once a year we should play a national. So those times were different. Now if you compare, it's definitely changed. Definitely.
And you were talking about people are not ready to invest. So right now, is this like, has the government funding increased, or are there private sponsors coming? What sort of changes are there?
Definitely, I cannot talk about this money part, who's investing in. We have our sponsors in the federations. We have, whenever we go for any international tour, it's the government who's helping us to, you know, travel this international match. So it's a lot of hands put in together. Mm-hmm. But then we cannot name any person who's sponsoring, and federation cannot, we cannot just take any local sponsors. So whatever is linked through federation, we can go to that. But I think definitely the things have been improved, and we are getting better facilities.
This is also in terms of, because the players, if they're not getting proper full-time contracts, and it also affects their play time. If they're not able to play full-time, then of course they won't be able to progress as players.
That's a wrong thing, you know. We think national team will give them money, or national team will do a contract with them. It's about, because the club culture is not around. Normally, it's, if you see any boys or men's team or any international, like abroad teams, they always been in a contract with the club, and they just come to play for the national team. They hardly get any money for that. It's just the name. But then here now, what happened? We don't have a club culture, so we always think federation has to do it. So that's something wrong. And then, but still, I think what federation is paying them, it's a good money. What we get earlier, I don't want to say what is it's now. Earlier we should get 25 rupees. So now it's much better what the girls are getting. Per day allowance what they get. The stay is there free. It's food is the best food what they get, because it's like all the physios take care of the diet and things. So it's the best food they get. Back home, I'm sure if I'm also at my home, I will not have a big meal breakfast. I will just have maybe one fruit, maybe some porridge and some bread and some toast. But when you are in the camp, you have different things to have, and it's the proper diet. So I think once a player comes to a camp, they have all these facilities. So I think cannot criticize for anything like that.
Okay, and also coming to the Indian Women's League, how do you feel the league has progressed since it started in terms of the players, the clubs, and in terms of the media coverage it's getting?
Definitely, as you know, earlier what teams we had, now we have 12 teams. So again, that has become better. The media coverage has become better. We are on Facebook Live. A lot of people watching it. If you have just put it on, there are a lot of people watching it. So that's one thing where we are getting attention. That also comes with the national team results. So it's all, I think, linked with results. And I think players are getting well paid in this league. At least I know all my national players are with the different clubs. Everybody is playing with a good amount of money. So it's not like earlier we should play for free. So now nothing comes free. So now everybody is getting paid. Clubs are taking interest. 2-3 clubs who have really paid the players well, and some young teams are there which they are getting better, and they have come for exposure, I think. So, but for us, it's like we can see a little more girls. Earlier it was like if 6 teams. So now this time it's like 12 teams. Better for us.
And can you talk about the preparations of the under 17? How is that going? How is the scouting process going? And you know, what are your general expectations from the Indian team, whatever is finalized?
We started, I'm in the scouting panel, so we started our scouting from Kolhapur, the junior nationals. So we selected some players. The camp has already started in Goa. So there are like 35 girls, the camp has started, and slowly now the coach will start shuffling the teams. More of scouting will be all over India. Lot of nationals happening, lot of tournaments happening for them. And think at the end of the year, we should get the best of the best girls for the World Cup team, because that's that biggest platform. So we will also work for it, and Federation also is doing a lot of things for them. So it's a lot of exposures for them. There is a lot of things. It's like we just need to sit and have patience, like believe in the women's team. I think they will do it a good job, for sure.
And finally, last question. What do you feel about the future of women's football in India, seeing that India has been given a chance to host the under 17?
I can just say it's growing. For sure, if you see earlier and what's happening, we had never had a World Cup. Like, we had never participated in a World Cup. So this is first ever time. So you can see a lot of things happening for women's football. In senior team, you have seen the results coming up, young team. So I think it's just the time and patience, and everybody needs to believe in the women's team or the girls' team. It's just that. And I think it'll do better.
Thank you, Maymol Rocky, for talking to us today. And thank you for watching this clip.
Pleasure. Thank you.